Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse racket review of the all-new Barbalar Pure Drive Plus. Updated with Barbalar's HDR system, which strengthens the hoop for more power and stability, the Pure Drive Plus is perfect for players looking to dominate the court with power and spin. An average strung weight of 11.2 ounces combines with a 324 swing weight to provide easy access to fast swings while also offering some useful plow-through power. A crisp and direct 69 RA stiffness is kept in check by Barbalar's Cortex Pure Field Comfort technology.
Very happy to be here today to talk about Barbalar's new refinement, the updated 2021 Pure Drive Plus. A lot of people are aware that I really like these extended length frames, getting a lot out of them. I kind of flip-flop between the new Pure Drive Standard 300 gram and the Tour and this one, playing with them. And I have to say, between the three, this one is the most lively and powerful. I had the least effort required to get the ball deep in the court. I would say a deceptively powerful racket, maybe akin to the E-Zone 100 plus. So power was on tap. I actually had to learn how to harness it. The full bed of the monofilament absolutely complements this frame. And once you get it under control, you're really not having to exert a lot of effort to stay in points, to dictate, to change pace. I actually got more out of this racket with a 6-point headlight balance as I did to the 4-point headlight balance of the 300 gram. Even though it's more tip light, it's not as maneuverable. So again, if you're looking for that racket that's really comfort oriented, a great versatile racket from any part of the court, I'm gonna say this is definitely worth a try. In terms of it being different from the prior Plus, Chris spoke to the HTR system, the high or higher torsional rigidity frame construction. It did do a lot in terms of keeping the comfort level pretty high, but also increasing stability. And then lastly, I know they extended the Pure Feel up the Y in the throat a little bit further, so it does do a little bit better job at sponging up vibration. All in all, great frame. Great play test.
Just like Booney mentioned, it was fun to get out on court with this one. I used to be a Pure Drive Plus user. I switched to the 2015 version, I think it was, of this racket and really enjoyed the extended length and then got right back into my comfort zone hitting with this one. This one I found it's off even more power than the old one I used. Definitely at a higher launch angle coming off the string bed. Had me spraying my forehand a little long at first until I got it dialed in, just adding a bit more spin on the ball. Just like that previous version too that I used to use, I prefer a nice stiff dead poly. We've got RPM Blast at 53 pounds in this one right now, and that works great for my game. Love this racket on the backhand slice. I really feel like I can just flick my wrist, knife it down the line, or pull it cross court just at the last second to keep my opponent guessing. So I feel like I can be aggressive and have a lot of disguise on that shot with this racket. And then on serve too, just a ton of power, great spin. So the ball's really moving through the court. And then I can follow that in, and I've liked the response at nets. Nice and crisp, we just point the racket where you want the ball to go, and it really gets in and out quickly and goes right there. I think Barbalar did a good job of muting some of the stiffness of the racket. It makes it very comfortable and offers a nice solid feel out there on the court too, so fun play test for me. Let's check in with our play testers on the East Coast now to see what they thought of this new Pure Drive Plus. Eric, how did this one work out for you?
Thanks, Chris. I absolutely loved this Pure Drive Plus. It was such a great racket. It's a racket that honestly I never thought I needed in my life. I loved how heavy and how deep I could hit balls. It was super easy. I got tons of plow through from this racket. On defense, I really loved how whippy this racket was and how it came through the ball. I just felt like it was an extension of my hand and I could really make sure I kept hitting the balls deep and keeping my opponents back at the baseline even when I was on the run. Up at net, I really loved the volleys. I feel like it was super solid. Definitely loved the feel of this racket. I felt very connected to the ball. I could hit my volleys deep and hit some nice touch volleys whenever I wanted, which is great. On serves, I loved how powerful I could hit my serves, but especially I really liked the amount of spin and depth I got out of my serves, especially on kick serves, just to get a little bit more safety on my shots and a little bit more margin. On returns, I really loved blocking the returns back off the first serve as I usually do. I could get them nice and deep, really easy to do that. And on second serves, I loved attacking and keeping my opponents deep. But overall, this is a racket that honestly I'm considering switching to, and you should definitely give it a demo.
This updated Pure Drive Plus stood true to the Pure Drive name in that it offered up easy access to power, spin, and depth. It did take me a minute to adjust to this frame as I had come from hitting some pretty lightweight, whippy rackets, and so I did notice that extra length at first and the different feel of this one coming around the body, but I was quick to adapt and realize that I didn't need such a big motion to get the same result out of this frame as it just packed so much punch and plow and just offered effortless depth off of the string bed, and it was really stable from around the court. So whether I was playing offensive or defensive, it just offered a really solid response, and I felt like I was always hitting a really heavy ball. Maybe the one area I got tripped up from the back of the court was if I was pushed out wide on a ground stroke and I wanted to hit that aggressive shot down the line. I felt like this came around a little bit too slow for that, so I opted more for a defensive or neutral shot in those situations. But overall, I found this to be just a really fun racket with to play with from the back of the court. And then moving forward, I had no complaints. It felt super stable, easy to punch balls deep, and also easy to direct the ball into the open court for a winner, so no issues there. On serves, this didn't have quite the same crisp response off the string bed as the previous model, so I needed a minute to get dialed into the feel. But what stood out to me was how consistent I could get my serve. My serves were landing deep in the box. I could get great access to spin, and the more I served with it, the more I could get used to that feel overhead and really tap into some nice power and take advantage of that extra reach. Overall, I found this racket to really bring the heat on court, and if you're a fan of extended length frames, I think this one is going to be one that you'll easily adapt to. We strung up the Babolat Pure Drive Plus with Babolat's RPM Blast and RPM Power at around 53 pounds. For more information on this racket or others, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.